Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion. This is lecture number 29 in Gas Dynamics and Jet Propulsion, and we are going to discuss the aircraft propulsion part 2. So in the earlier lecture also we discussed the aircraft propulsion. We continue with the aircraft propulsion. In the earlier lecture, we discussed the turbo propeller engine, turbo jet engine, turbo fan engine, ramjet engine, pulse jet engine, and the scramjet engine. The working principle of various jet engine and their advantages and disadvantages we have discussed. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss the performance of jet engines. We said in the earlier lecture that there are many components like diffuser, compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, nozzle, and propeller in the jet engines. So, we are going to discuss the performance of all the devices, efficiency of all the devices, and we are going to calculate the efficiency of the jet engine and the thrust produced by the jet engine. The learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the students will be able to explain the flow through diffuser, compressor, combustion chamber, turbine and the nozzle, and calculate the efficiency, various efficiency of the jet engine. The first device is diffuser. So, in the flow through jet engine, the first device is diffuser. For the diffuser, HOI equal to HO1, the stagnation enthalpy remains constant. HOI equal to HI plus C1 square by 2. The enthalpy entropy diagram of the diffuser is shown here. So, the PI is the pressure at the inlet of the diffuser, P1 is the pressure at the outlet of the diffuser for actual diffusion process, P1S, this point is P1S, is the isentropic pressure at the end of the process, end of the diffusion process. So, the HOI equal to HO1, so HI plus CI square by 2. So, CI square is the velocity at the entrance of the diffuser, C1 is the velocity at the outlet of the diffuser. So, CI square, HI plus CI square by 2 equal to H1 plus C1 square by 2. So, in terms of temperature, we may write as Ti plus T1 square by 2 Cp equal to T1 plus C1 square by 2 Cp. So, this is the enthalpy relationship for the diffusion process. Stagnation enthalpy remains constant. The efficiency of the diffuser, eta D equal to static pressurize in the actual diffusion process divided by static pressurize in the isentropic diffusion process. So, the actual diffusion process is I to 1. The isentropic diffusion process is I to 1S. So, the efficiency of the diffuser equal to P1 minus PI divided by P1S minus PI. The pressure ratio of the diffuser P1 by PI equal to T1 by TI to the power gamma by gamma minus 1. The next device is compressor. So, the air after leaving the diffuser, it enters the compressor. So, in the compressor, it is undergoing compression process. Compressor is a mechanical device driven by the turbine. So, using the mechanical power, it increases the pressure of the air. So, the 1 to 2 is the actual compression process, 1 to 2 S is the isentropic compression process. So, here again there is increase in enthalpy and entropy of the air. The actual work input to the compressor is WA equal to HO2 minus HO1, isentropic work input to the compressor WS equal to HO2S minus HO1. So, HO1 including the velocity component. So, we calculate in terms of the stagnation enthalpy. And the efficiency of the compressor, eta C equal to isentropic work input divided by the actual work input. So, isentropic work input is HO2S minus HO1 divided by HO2 minus HO1. So, in terms of temperature, because the fluid handled by the compressor is air, for air, enthalpy H equal to Cp into T. So, in terms of temperature, we may write the efficiency equation as TO2S minus TO1 divided by TO2 minus TO1. So, in the numerator, we take TO1 outside. So, this becomes TO1 into TO2S by TO1 minus 1 divided by TO2 minus TO1. So, this is equal to TO1. This temperature ratio, stagnation temperature ratio is in terms of pressure ratio PO2S by PO1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1 divided by TO2 minus TO1. This is the efficiency of the compressor. The next is the combustion chamber where the fuel is injected. The combustion of the fuel and the air takes place in the combustion chamber. So, the heat gained by the gas QS equal to MA plus MF into HO3 minus ma into HO2. ma is the mass of the air, mf is the mass of the fuel, HO3 is the enthalpy of the gas at the outlet of the combustion chamber, HO2 is the enthalpy of the air at the inlet of the combustion chamber. So the combustion efficiency, eta b equal to heat gained by the gas divided by heat supplied by fuel, by burning the fuel. So numerator is ma plus mf into HO3 minus ma into HO2 divided by heat supplied by the fuel by burning is mf into calorific value of the fuel. Mf is the mass of the fuel, Cv is the calorific value. And here we rearrange the equation. So in the numerator we take mf, ma outside. So when you take ma outside, ma 1 plus mf divided by ma into HO3 minus HO1 divided by mf by ma. So dividing by ma throughout. So we will get this equation. This is 1 plus f divided by 1 plus f into HO3 minus HO divided by f into Cv, where f is the fuel air ratio, mass of the fuel divided by mass of the air, and Cv is the calorific value of the fuel. So ma is the mass of the air in kilogram per second, mf is the mass of the fuel in kilogram per second, f is the fuel air ratio, and Cv is the calorific value of the fuel. Then the next device is turbine. So turbine is expanding the gases and to produce the work. So the work is used by the compressor. So the expansion, again there are two types of expansion, isentropic expansion and actual expansion. The isentropic expansion is given by 3 to 4 years, actual expansion is given by 3 to 4. So the enthalpy we have to calculate, H4S, HO4S. So the actual work output of the turbine, WA equal to HO3 minus HO4, and the isentropic work output of the turbine, WS equal to HO3 minus HO4S. Now the turbine efficiency is defined by actual work output divided by the isentropic work output, which is HO3 minus HO4 divided by HO3 minus HO4S. So as in the compressor, we express the enthalpy in terms of temperature. So this becomes TO3 minus TO4 divided by TO3 minus TO4S. So numerator as it is TO3 minus TO4. Denominator we take TO3 outside, TO3 into 1 minus TO4S by TO3. This TO4S divided by TO3 is the temperature ratio for the isentropic expansion. We express in terms of pressure ratio, and this becomes TO3 minus TO4 divided by TO3 into 1 minus 1 by PO3 by PO4 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1. So where PO3 by PO4 equal to the pressure ratio of the turbine, stagnation pressure ratio of the turbine. Then the exhaust nozzle. So this is the enthalpy entropy diagram of the nozzle. So the gas after expanding the turbine enters the nozzle, where it is expanded further to produce the velocity. So the inlet conditions are 4. 4 is the inlet condition for the nozzle, and outlet is E, exit condition. So the actual expansion of the nozzle is 4 to E. Isentropic expansion nozzle is 4 to ES. For expansion process in the nozzle, HO4 equal to HOE. So HO4 equal to HE plus CE square by 2. So the velocity of the jet CE equal to square root of 2 into HO4 minus HE, which is equal to square root of 2 CP into TO4 minus PE. So the efficiency of the nozzle, nozzle efficiency equal to actual enthalpy drop divided by the isentropic enthalpy drop. In terms of static pressure, static conditions, H4 minus HE divided by H4 minus HES, which is T4 minus TE. In terms of temperature, TE4 minus TE divided by T4 minus TES. So denominator for isentropic process, we modify in terms of pressure ratio. So numerator as it is, T4 minus TE divided by T4 into 1 minus TES divided by T4, which is equal to T4 minus TE divided by T4 into 1 minus PE by P4 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this is the efficiency of the nozzle. So we discuss the various devices, diffuser, compressor, combustion chamber, turbine and the nozzle, and we calculate the efficiency of all the devices. Then we calculate the performance of the jet engine. We calculate the thrust. So thrust is the force produced by the jet engine. So we calculate the thrust. First we calculate the propeller thrust. So the propeller, when the propeller is available, so propeller, first propeller jet engine, we have a propeller. If there is no propeller, we can ignore the propeller thrust. So the propeller, the boundary of the propeller is marked on the outside. So the velocity, the air is entering with the velocity C1 equal to U. Ma is the mass of the air entering the propeller area. and there is a, I mean, the air is leaving the end of the jet engine with the velocity C2, which is CJ. CJ is the jet velocity or jet speed. So, MA is the mass of the air flow through the propeller. C1 is the velocity of the air at the inlet. C2 is the velocity of the air at the outlet. U is the flight speed and CJ is the jet speed. And if you look at the here in the diagram, C1, air velocity at the entry of the propeller equal to U, which is the flight speed. Because the flight is moving with the velocity U, the air is entering into the propeller or into the engine with the same speed in the opposite direction. And the jet is leaving the jet engine with the velocity CJ, which is equal to the outlet velocity of the gas jet. So, it is the basic principle. The thrust produced by the propeller and the aircraft is equal to the change in the momentum of air between and the inlet and the outlet. So, it is based on the Newton's second law of motion, F equal to M into A. The thrust force produced by the aircraft engine, that is equal to rate of change of momentum of air between inlet and the outlet. So, F equal to M into C2 minus C1. So, C2 is the velocity, momentum, change in momentum equal to mass into change in velocity. So, F equal to M into A, that is what? Mass into acceleration. Acceleration is change in velocity is the C2 minus C1. So, F equal to MA into C2 minus C1. So, we said C2 equal to CJ and C1 equal to U. So, F equal to MA into CJ minus U. Now, we modify the equation, rearrange the equation, MA into U. U is the velocity of the speed of the vehicle. So, U into CJ by U minus 1. So, which is also written as MA into U into 1 by sigma minus 1. Where sigma is the flight speed to jet speed ratio, U by CJ. So, sigma value is plays very significant role in the performance of the jet engine. Sigma equal to jet speed ratio or flight speed ratio. So, U by CJ, which is flight speed divided by the jet speed. And the jet thrust, now we calculate the jet, earlier we calculate the propeller thrust, now we calculate the jet thrust. So, thrust produced by the gas jet is the jet thrust. In the turbofan engine, the jet thrust is the sum of the gas jet thrust and the cold air thrust. So, in the turbo propeller engine, we have the jet thrust, gas jet thrust plus propeller thrust. In the turbo jet engine, we have only the jet thrust. In the turbo fan engine, we have cold jet thrust and the hot jet thrust. So, there are different combinations. So, depending on the type of the engine, we have to take one particular, the required equation for calculating the thrust produced by the engine. So, here we calculate the jet thrust, both cold thrust and the hot thrust. So, the air entering with the velocity U and the PA is the pressure. PA is the pressure and it is leaving with the pressure PE and velocity CE. And we have the force acting in the opposite direction. The net thrust equal to momentum thrust plus the pressure thrust. So, F, momentum thrust F, MOM, momentum thrust equal to rho E CE square AE minus rho I U square into AI. AE, AI, they are the inlet and the outlet exit area. Inlet and the exit area. CE is the jet speed. U is the vehicle speed. Rho E is the density at the exit. Rho I is the density of air at the inlet. Mass flow rate at the inlet, MA equal to rho I U into A. So, mass flow rate at the outlet equal to ME equal to MA plus MF, which is equal to rho E CE into A. Therefore, MOM equal to MA plus MF into CE minus MA into U. So, the momentum thrust equal to MA plus MF into CE minus MA into U. Now, the mass of the fuel is very less comparing with the mass of the air. So, momentum thrust MA plus MF into CE minus MA into U equal to MA into CE minus U. So, MF is negligible comparing with the mass of the air. So, the pressure thrust acting on the aircraft engine, FPR equal to PE minus PA into AE. So, the net thrust equal to MA into CE minus U plus PE minus PA into AE. So, the net thrust with respect to the effective jet velocity, so this MA into CJ minus U. So, this is the final equation. So, the net thrust is the sum of the pressure thrust and the momentum thrust, which is also expressed as mass of the air into CJ minus U. CJ is the velocity of the jet and U is the speed of the vehicle. And we discussed the efficiency. The first efficiency is propulsion efficiency. eta p equal to propulsive power or the thrust power divided by power output of the engine. So the propulsive power equal to the thrust into velocity, m into cj minus u into velocity u, and the power output of the engine is 1 by 2 m into cj square minus u square. So simplifying, this becomes m is getting cancelled, so we'll get 2u by cj plus u, because cj square minus u square equal to cj minus u into cj plus u, so cj minus u is getting cancelled, you will get eta p equal to 2u by cj plus u. You take u to the denominator, 2 divided by cj by u plus 1. So cj by u, so u by cj we defined earlier as sigma, so eta p equal to 2 by 1 by sigma plus 1, so which is equal to 2 sigma by 1 plus sigma, where sigma is the effective speed ratio. So sigma we defined u by cj earlier. So the propulsive efficiency eta p equal to 2 sigma by 1 plus sigma, where sigma is the effective speed ratio. And thermal efficiency of the jet engine. So power output of the engine divided by power input of the engine through the fuel. So power output of the engine is 1 by 2 m into cj square minus u square. Power input of the engine through fuel equal to mf into cv. So in terms of fuel air ratio, we take the cj square minus u square divided by 2 f into cv. So 1 by 2 is taken to the denominator, where f equal to mf by ma. So the fuel air ratio, f is the fuel air ratio. So thermal efficiency equal to cj square divided by 2f into cv into 1 minus sigma square. So this is again substituting the sigma in sigma, which is equal to u square minus u square by cj square. Then overall efficiency eta o equal to propulsive power divided by power input to the engine through fuel, which is m into cj minus u into u divided by mf into cv, which is the product of thermal efficiency and the propulsive efficiency. Then we calculate the performance parameter, thrust specific fuel consumption. So TSFC equal to mass of fuel consumed per newton of thrust produced, unit thrust produced. So mass of the fuel divided by thrust produced, that is what the TSFC. Thrust, the amount of fuel consumed to produce unit thrust is the TSFC, which is mass of the fuel divided by the thrust produced by the jet engine. Then we calculate the specific thrust, FS equal to M by F by M. So the thrust produced divided by mass flow rate through the propulsion system. So the specific thrust is defined as the amount of thrust produced per kg of the fluid flow or air flow through the system. And the specific impulse IS equal to F by W, which is thrust produced divided by weight flow rate through the propulsion system. So this is specific thrust is F divided by M, mass flow rate. And the specific impulse is IS equal to F divided by W, is the weight flow rate through the propulsive system. So C M into CJ minus U divided by M into G, so which is U by G into 1 by sigma minus 1, specific impulse. So we stop here. So the performance parameter we discussed in this lecture, using the various performance parameters, in the next lecture, we will solve problems in the aircraft propulsion from the problems we take from the unionized question paper. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in mechanical engineering subject. You may find the gas dynamics and jet propulsion book. You can refer to the book for additional information in this subject and on the problem in the subject. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the video lectures for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again in the next video lecture with additional problem in the aircraft propulsion. Until then, bye bye.